How's it going, guys? Welcome to another video. Today I'm going to be playing the Grand Tour game. It's my first time playing, so yeah. So I've actually seen all the episodes. So yeah. Yep, there's explosions. This is gonna be quite fun. Oh yeah, we watched the whole episode, so. It'd be nice to have a recap. Los Angeles. Oh, look at that. These episodes are going to be quite long, I just realised that. There we go. Done that. I just realized what that is now. Look at that. I've never heard of this Mustang before. Yep, there we go. First position. And here's everyone. There's everything. Oh, the Lamborghini. I'll let the episodes play as some of you might not be able to see these.
Gentlemen,
I can't wait to play that one.
There's no dignity in that, is there?
Nah.
tour.
Could it be more Kari if it tried? And I'm going to prove that point because we're kicking off with this.
I agree too.
Various supercar makers are now taking the sort of polar bear friendly technology from Price, and they're now using it to create raw naked speed. Now I say the better these hybrid cars is the mad swiveloid McLaren E1, whereas Richard Hamilton, wrong.
I'm not.
He is, because he says the best is actually the rather boring Porsche 911.
It's not boring.
My favorite one is the P1. No, oh, I'm racing. I can see why people say the game is like no other. But I can also see why. How people say it isn't the most easy game to control, which I disagree. I think it's a good easy game to control the cars in. So here I'm driving a Porsche 918. Whoa, okay. I don't know how I feel about the drifting. Alright, the drifting is awful in this game. No, the drifting in this game is way too hard.
This is brilliant.
So this one I have to try not to crash. I don't want to get bronze, so... Really? Does that...
phone box with a panicking gorilla.
Rubbish.
It was trying to kill me. It wants to hurt me. It wants to hurt me.
That's why I like it.
Razor blade in the hands of a surgeon. Sickle in the hands of a drunk peasant.
Scooter of sherry. Absinthe.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I'm here because, gentlemen, I have in the back of that lorry. Something that will make your McLaren and your Porsche look like lumps of yesterday.
Could it be? That looks like a Ford GT, but I know it isn't. It is a... Oh, it's a Ferrari. I know what it is. LaFerrari. Oh, I just lost it now.
What we have here, then, are three incredible machines which at a stroke have made the traditional supercar look wooden and old-fashioned. Welcome everyone to the Hypercar Holy Trinity.
Do I have to P1? The P1 was actually the slowest, so... Alright. That was fast. Catch back up with Jamie. No. If I didn't have that second thrust, I don't think I'd get it. That's good. Here we go.
Yours is the better milk float.
describe the hotel. It gives us a chance to see what they're like on the road.
That's a good point.
Real world.
Is a good point.
I can't do that. I can't. Well, I can't drive the Ferrari on the road.
Why?
It's not registered.
It is, but not
the plates. No, let's just pretend they're the plates. If they register it, it becomes second-hand and they have to pay the tax. That's why it came in a long.
So you can't drive it on the road, do you?
Nobody can drive it. It's not road legal.
Oh,
no,
that's such a shame.
Oh, sorry, James. That's really a wrong bit of luck, because you've come a long way from it.
Really need to talk a lot more about the game. At the moment I quite like it, the only thing that annoys me is like the drifting, it's not very good. I got silver, I'll take it. I'm driving this. Back down the isn't.
If you make a mistake, there's no runoff area, it's just woods.
because it's right next to a house where an old lady lives. Get this 90 left right or you'll crash into a cage full of electricity. And you'll need to get the final 90 left right as well or you'll run into a female sheep.
No, just over a minute. Yeah, the drifting's messed up in this game. You can't, like, it's either that way or that way. It's no, there's no balance in it. Like, if I try and correct it so I don't hit a wall, I just go and hit. I go straight the other way. So, I'm not gonna get gold on this one. I'm gonna get silver though. First trophy.
Straight.
Now back on the isn't. Up to old lady's house. And we're into old lady's house. On the way down. Ah, just. Oh, this is after. I guess this one is petrol.
Naturally, this meant engaging launch control, which in the McLaren takes about a fortnight.
I have to have the drive train in track mode, aero package in sport mode, so that the rear end squats when I set off and gives me more traction. I have to have the DRS button pressed with my thumb to keep the rear wing open, which reduces drag, obviously.
Launch control in the Porsche, left foot on the brake, hard, right foot on the throttle, hard. Light goes green, left foot on the brake, ding!
Launch button pressed 2 seconds, left foot on brake, right foot on throttle,
press launch control, mash the throttle, within 4 seconds, release the brake.
3 seconds later, I have full boost and I have to set off then within 3 seconds or the entire system disengages.
After it's finally set up, can I use the McLaren drive the choice or not? I don't think I've got the choice, do I? This thing's fast.
Yeah.
this, we were interested to hear his professional opinion.
La McLaren, voiture, je pense peut-être la plus difficile à piloter. Très facile de faire une erreur, c'est vraiment une voiture de grand garçon. Il faut faire attention et donc pas facile de faire un tour. Je pense qu'elle est un peu moins efficace.
At this point, word reached us that Jeremy was taking liberties with the subtitling machine. So we moved on to the big event, the timed lapse. Once the mechanics had finished their preparations, the three speed traps were activated. And the Ferrari
Alright, so here we go.
Good it looks there.
Because of the stripes, do you think?
Much. I do like the stripes and stuff on top of it. Trying to get the best line possible. So we've got it now, so here we go. Back on the main straight.
That's not the fastest. We can knock your house.
Yep.
You know where it is. You both been.
I'd love to knock it down.
Here we go. A lot riding on this.
So I've got to try to be the fastest. Be 150 miles an hour, come on. To be 140. Yep, that one. So at the moment, it's technically it's winning. Trying to get the hang of drifting on this.
With that, back to the tent.
It was the fastest, so. And that was the end. All right. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.